Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Thursday, the 12th of July, 2012. Coming at you with some updates in this video here today. First thing I want to talk about, last weekend we had three underage drinking incidents. Reminder that the legal drinking age here in Japan is 20. So if you're not 20 years or older, you shouldn't be drinking in the first place. And if you do drink, even if you're of age, you don't drink to excess. Kind of easy for us to spot the underage drinker when he's passed out on the ground. That's usually a good indication he's had too much to drink. All right, so please, let's be responsible out there with the ignorant oil. Let's not get any more trouble or anything of that nature. On the bright side, though, we just hit day 60 without a DUI. 60 consecutive days with no DUIs. We are now on the right trend. We are on a pace to be under last year's. I want to continue that. Let's not let it stop now. It's at 60. Let's see if we can get like 360 or something of that nature. But please keep up the good effort on not getting behind the wheel of a vehicle after you have consumed alcohol. We've had several reports lately of we get alarms, the fire department responds, due to unattended cooking. In other words, people are burning their food, it's setting off the fire alarms and stuff. You've seen some of the commercials on TV. Please, don't leave your cooking unattended, especially if it's something that can start catching into flames and calling out the fire department for a false alarm. So please pay attention to that. Just a reminder about let's not have the potty mouths around the base. The kids are out for the summer. Everybody, this is a general audience base. Let's watch the language. There's a time and place for anything, for everything, and that includes foul language. Yeah, I understand if you drop a pop-up on the softball field, maybe you drop a four-letter word, but not just walking around the playgrounds and over in the NEX complex or the food court or things of that nature. So please, let's watch the potty mouths around the installation. On Monday, there's going to be an all-hands call at Fleet Theater. That's going to run from 1325 to 1440. This is going to be with the SECNAV. Uniform will be NWUs. This is an opportunity for all sailors in the Yokosuka area that are forward deployed to go ask questions of the SECNAV. So there's a good opportunity for you to take advantage of that. We ought to get max participation. And again, that is going to be on Monday at Fleet Theater starting at 1325. So if you want to get in, I recommend you get there probably at least 15 minutes earlier than that, at least. All right. On the 14th, this Saturday, we have got a farmer's market going on. That will occur outside Kearney Gate area. This will probably be the last farmer's market we're going to do with the city, by the looks of it, because they're going to be opening a permanent farmer's market about 10, 15 minutes from the base here later this year. But here's a chance for you to come down, see some of the fresh produce that is grown here in Japan by the local farmers. So if you want to, that'll be from 10 o'clock to 12:30 on Saturday. And then up in Kurihama on Saturday, there's going to be a festival. There's going to be a parade, and they're going to be doing, I think, fireworks that night. So if you're in the Kurihama area, you might see some activities going on up there on Saturday as well. Tuesday next week, we're going to be having the SAPR visit. That's the Department of the Navy's Sexual Assault Prevention and Response Team. They're going to be putting on a production over at Fleet Theater from 1300 to 1500. It's called No Zebras. It's the Zebra production, and it talks about sexual assault and awareness and things that we need to know really well. And they're sending out the experts here on next week. They'll be here on Tuesday. So that production is on Tuesday, again, at Fleet Theater, starting at 1300. We got a lot of change of commands coming up here. On the 27th, there's two of them that day alone, the hospital and the Blue Ridge. There will be some road closures over by the Blue Ridge during their change of command that evening. So please, we'll get more information out on that, but be aware that there will be some road closures and things of that nature when that change of command is happening. As a reminder, on the 4th of August is our big Friendship Day. That's when we open up the base. Expect about 40 to 50,000 people to come on that day. Fireworks that evening, lots of events. So that one's coming up here fast and furious. You might notice the electric billboard that we use down there just on King Street after you come through the main gate. Half of it hasn't been working for a long time. They're going to be replacing that billboard now. They're starting to set up to do that. We're going to get a new one. It's going to be more energy efficient. It's going to be LEDs. And the only real ramification there while they're doing the installation is about a half dozen parking spots in the 12-hour parking are going to be secured for a laydown area. So just keep that in mind. You'll see some construction going on that, and that's why the billboard isn't turned on today, because they're getting ready to replace it. Hey, this Saturday also is a Captain's Cup event. 14th of July on Saturday will be the Ultimate Frisbee. So get out there and play Ultimate Frisbee. Remember, we want to dethrone Subgroup 7 and shut up the mouth that cannot be ignored and Lauren. But this Saturday, get your teams out there and play some Ultimate. Reminder on energy conservation, we're still putting a push on that. And I received notice today that the Department of Energy has awarded CFAY the 2011 Energy and Water Management Awards. So that reflects what we did last summer and we did over the last year. We can continue on this trend. So be smart, you know, turn lights out in rooms when you're not there. Don't crank up the ACs. You see some efforts going around the base already, like we've got some street lights secured, not using the fountains. So be smart there with the energy, and we can continue to excel at that. We don't have a date yet on this, but we do have 3D movie capabilities going to be coming to the base. I think there's somebody pulled the trigger a little early, making people think we already have it. We do not. We're waiting on the dates we're going to get it from CNIC. Hopefully that'll be before this year is over, but we are planning on getting 3D movie capability here at the installation in our theaters. We're just waiting for the contracted dates to come in and let us know when we're going to get that. We're getting closer, not yet, we got close but no cigar, on Chili's being able to take credit cards again. They've got their new equipment in. It's being certified, being verified. So hopefully here before much longer, I can tell you that you can use credit cards at Chili's. But for now, and I don't have a date yet, it's still cash only. So remember, when you go to Chili's, it's cash only for the current time being, until we can get this finally rectified and get the new equipment that's PKI compliant and PII certified, so that we won't have a situation like we did before. Next week on Wednesday, we're going to have an open galley. This is in honor of Independence Day and Independence Month. So lunchtime at the galley next week. Open galley. You can come to the galley and enjoy a good meal there. All right, on to the trivia. Well, this is going to be kind of easy for me this week, because nobody tried to answer any of the questions I asked last week. So I'm going to use the same questions I did last week. And I actually skipped over a question last week. I only said two when I had three. So I got three trivia questions here. Two of them I put out last week and haven't gotten an answer to. And I thought these kind two were kind of easy, actually. The song I'm looking for, here are the lyrics. Went to a party the other night. All the ladies were treating me right. Moving my feet to the disco beat. How in the world could I keep my seat? All right, so I think you guys can figure that one out pretty quick. And this one, I think you should be able to get right away. This is a movie. This 1954 Japanese film starts near and on Odo Island, where poor fishing is being blamed on by the fishermen by a sea god. What is the name of this movie? This classic movie from the 1950s. And here's the question I forgot to ask last week, and I'm going to put it out this week. The All-Star game was played earlier this week. In fact, it was played yesterday. The National League won 8-0. But who has hit the most home runs in All-Star games? I'll give you a hint. The number is 6. Who has hit the most home runs in All-Star games? And with that, CFAY, as usual, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great weekend, CFAY.